All the nigga wanna have was a very big scarf and $3 in my pocket. Instead I got beat with a switch, but I don't give a fuck, but it's on my body. Scars all up on me, but I run around from everybody. Life lesson learned, I better learn from this bitch, nobody. She pushed me around, she didn't give no motherfucks about it. She broke my heart 3 times, but I ain't getting...
The Indianapolis Colts are going to be traveling on the road to face the Detroit Lions. This was a game that I did not initially plan on talking about this week. But when I was in the shower, I was thinking about the Detroit Lions. And for a lot of you guys who are watching this, you're probably going to be like, JT, why are you thinking about the Detroit Lions in the shower, you weirdo? Here's what a lot of you guys have to understand. I love sports. I love talking about sports. This is why I have a YouTube channel named JT Sports, because my name's JT and I love talking about sports. But football is my favorite sport. I live, eat, sleep, and breathe football. When I'm on the toilet, I'm thinking about football. When I'm doing my online classes, I'm thinking about football. When I'm taking a shower, I'm thinking about football. When I wake up, I'm thinking about football. When I'm asleep, sometimes I may be dreaming about football. So football is always on my mind 24/7. And I was thinking about the Lions. They are currently 3-3 right now. They have a record of 500. If they beat the Colts this week, they will be 4-3. They will have a record of above 500. And they will be right in the middle of things when it comes to the NFC playoff race. And the Chicago Bears, who happens to be second in the division, are 5-2. They have to face the Saints this week. And that is the game that I think the Bears have a pretty good chance of losing. So if the Bears lose to the Saints and the Lions manage to beat the Colts this week, they will be in a pretty good spot to not only take over that second spot in the division, but with the way that their November schedule lines up, the Detroit Lions have a really good shot of making it to the playoffs. Remind you, after this game, here are who the Detroit Lions have to play for the rest of the month of November. The Vikings, Washington, and Carolina. Neither three of those teams have a winning record. And they cap off the end of November by playing the Houston Texans. So the best team out of those four opponents that they face this month, aside from the Indianapolis Colts who they played this week, are pretty much the Carolina Panthers. So all four of those games are very winnable games. As a matter of fact, I think that Detroit pretty much be favored to win 3 out of 4 of those games. So if the Lions are able to win those games, and let's say they go 8-3, 7-4 heading into the month of December, they're going to be in a pretty good spot to not only have that second place spot in the division, but they're also going to be in a really good spot in terms of making it to the playoffs. Now, their schedule in December is absolutely tough. I believe they have to face the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and a couple of other tough opponents as well. So they have the easiest schedule in November, but they also have the hardest schedule out of any team in the NFL in the month of December. But if you're a Lions fan, you're facing this Colts team, and this is a pretty good Colts team. Now, the Colts are 4-2, and I think a lot of people are really sleeping on the Colts this year. And the Colts are a running football team without a doubt, okay? And the last time I watched the Colts play, they were able to hold off the Cincinnati Bengals and Joe Burrow. And Phillip Rivers played a pretty nice game. Now, for those of you guys who've been watching the channel ever since the season started, I've been saying this from the start. If Phillip Rivers has to throw the ball more than 30 times in the game, majority of the time, you're not really going to have a good chance of winning, because when Phillip Rivers has to throw the ball more than 30 times, the opportunity for turnovers is there, because that's just what Phillip Rivers is. The more he has to throw, the more you risk him throwing an interception or turning the football over. So you're the Detroit Lions, and you're Matt Patricia coming in here on a 2-game win streak. And I know a lot of people like to say the Detroit Lions haven't played anybody. Their last two opponents have been the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Atlanta Falcons, which they barely managed to walk out of there with a victory. But here's what a lot of people have to understand. Even though the Detroit Lions haven't played any good teams, really, and their biggest win this season has been against the Arizona Cardinals, I mean, you have to think about the confidence boost right now. This was a team that before their 2-game winning streak was 1-3, and Matt Patricia was on the verge of getting fired. Nobody really knows what's going on with the Detroit Lions locker room. So football is a mental game. And for the Detroit Lions, although a lot of you guys who are pretty much Colts fans may not be impressed with the Detroit Lions' recent wins, it's all about confidence. And having confidence can do wonders for you when it comes to playing football. Even though you may not be the best of teams, having confidence can really boost the morale in the locker room, and it can make people play at a high level. Let me give you guys a quick story. So I remember in seventh grade, I was playing on the middle school football team, which wasn't good. It's pretty much the worst team that I've ever played on in all my years playing, because every team that I played on from Pop Warner to sixth grade has always been pretty good. So in seventh grade, we were currently 0-3. And in middle school, there are only 8 games. So we were 0-3. And our next 4 games, we played against some of the worst teams in the city. So we win those 4 games. So we end up being 4-3. And the next game we played was against one of the best teams in that area. And the middle school that we played against, I forgot the name of it, but they went 5 years without losing a single game. They've been undefeated for 5 years. And a lot of people were saying that we didn't have a chance. But us as a team, even though we weren't great and we didn't play the best of opponents, like the teams that we beat didn't even have full rosters. They had like only like 25 guys on the team playing both sides of the football. So, I mean, even though those weren't the best of teams, we were really confident. So we went into that game against a team that went 5 straight years without losing, and we felt pretty good about ourselves. So we go into that game, and we ended up winning that game by a lucky safety. The quarterback fumbled the football. One of the guys were able to scoop it up, but he wasn't aware where he was, and we ended up getting a safety, and we ended up holding on to winning the game. So even though we weren't the best team, we had confidence. And when you have players playing with confidence that feel like there's nothing that they can't do, that believe in themselves, that is a really big thing. And a lot of you guys have to understand that football isn't just all about going on the field and knocking each other's brains out and trying to get big hits and things like that. Football is a mental game as well. A lot of people have to understand that football is not just the game of brute strength and force and who's the most athletic. It's also a game of chess, okay? So when you're in the NFL, it's all about mindset. The high school coach that I used to have said, or I think it was my 8th grade middle school coach, he said, mind over matter, okay? So for the Detroit Lions, they have a lot of confidence right now. And those 2 games that they played against the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Atlanta Falcons, they really needed those wins. Because now you have the locker room in a positive mindset. Now you have players that are actually somewhat starting to believe in Matt Patricia, even though they haven't played the best of teams. So, I mean, confidence is a really big thing for the Lions, especially when you look at how their seasons have went over the last couple of years. So, for the Colts, I mean, the Colts are walking into this thing 4-2. And for the Colts, you have one of the best defenses in the NFL statistically. You're 2nd in the NFL in pass yards per game allowed with 199.7 yards per game, yards per pass. You're 5th in the NFL. And opposing completion percentage, your opponents are only completing 61% of their passes, which is also 5th in the NFL. But is the Indianapolis Colts defense legit? And I still wonder this. Because the Colts faced the Jets, they kind of faced some non-good teams that are able to boost their stats a little bit. And last time I saw this Colts defense, they were getting carved up by Joe Burrow and the Cincinnati Bengals. So in this game, when I'm looking at the Indianapolis Colts, depending on how the Colts do or defense in this game is going to determine if this defense is actually legit or not. Because it's easy to look good when you're facing the New York Jets. And a lot of Colts fans got on me because I didn't talk about how great this defense was, which this defense is pretty good. But, I mean, you were facing the Jets. When you face the Cincinnati Bengals, you got carved up. So, I mean, you can't really blame me for not really having a lot of confidence. But if you want to prove me wrong, and the Colts want to show that they do indeed have one of the best defenses in the NFL, this would be the game to do so. With a Detroit Lions offense that is pretty good ever since they got wide receiver Kenny Galladay back, and they can actually run the football. DeAndre Swift has came on over the last couple of weeks. You also have Adrian Peterson, the man who doesn't seem to age. So Detroit, for the first time in a very long time since I can remember, is actually a pretty balanced football team. They can run the ball if they have to, and they can throw the ball if they need to. So for the Colts, on offense, are they going to be able to score in the red zone? The Colts have struggled mightily for the entire season being able to come up with points in the red zone. I'm not talking about 3 points. I'm talking about being able to walk away with touchdowns. They only score touchdowns in the red zone 52% of the time, which is 26th in the NFL. So if they want to win this game, I think you're going to have to be able to walk away with some touchdowns because the Detroit Lions, I don't think they're all that far off from the talent that the Colts have. The Lions have talent. It's all about coaching. So if you're a Colts fan and you're watching this, the Colts aren't really that more superior of a team than the Detroit Lions. The Colts have a better defense, but offensively, I think that the Lions are better than you. Because the game plan for beating the Colts isn't all that complicated. If you're able to stop the run game, you force Phillip Rivers to throw the football, you have a really good chance of winning the game. And the reason for that is what I said earlier, is the fact that the more Phillip Rivers throws the football, the more you increase your chances of getting a turnover. Because that's just what Phillip Rivers is. He's going to make some throws that he just tries to force the ball into double coverage, or he's just going to make some mistakes the more he throws the football. So if you Detroit, you take away that run game, and you force Phillip Rivers to throw the football, you're going to have a good opportunity of being able to get your hands on a couple of turnovers. Now, the team not going to take the win this game, I'm going to take the Indianapolis Colts to win this one. And the Lions have been pretty solid for the last two games. But, I mean, the Colts are favored to win this game by 3 points. I think that the Colts win by that margin. I think the Colts win 24-21. And the reason why is because I still don't really have a lot of faith in the Detroit Lions. I know a lot of Lions fans like to say a win is a win. And I know I gave like this long 5-minute tangent about confidence. But at the end of the day, Detroit still hasn't really impressed me, because they beat the Jaguars convincingly. You beat Atlanta. But if Todd Gurley would have instead fell down and never scored that touchdown, Atlanta would have won that game. And I know a win is a win. That's what a lot of Lions fans have told me over the last couple of days. But although it's a win, it's a win. How you win and the margin that you win can say a lot about you. Okay? Detroit beat Arizona. Even though they were +3 in the turnover margin, they were barely able to win that game. And I told a lot of Lions fans, I said, look, you beat Arizona, but you're not going to beat the Saints. And a lot of Lions fans got mad, but it was the truth. They ended up losing to the Saints. And the Saints game was pretty close, even though the Saints pretty much blowed out Detroit to start the game out. Detroit was able to come back in that game. But, I mean, I just don't really trust Detroit in this game. Like, and I don't really think a lot of Lions fans can blame me, because you were barely able to skate by Atlanta. Okay? So, you were barely able to skate by Atlanta, and I know every week is a different week, but I mean, I just don't really have a lot of confidence in Detroit. Now, even if Detroit does lose this game, they still have a very favorable schedule. I do think they can beat the Vikings, Washington, and the Texans. I don't know if they can beat Carolina. That's a toss-up game. We'll have to talk about that one when we get to it. But I mean, even if you lose this game, you're going to be in a pretty good spot, but I don't really have a lot of confidence in Detroit. If Detroit would have won that game against Atlanta more convincingly, like they would have beat Atlanta but like 3 points or but like a touchdown, I would have chose Detroit to win this game, because I would have had a little bit more confidence in Detroit. But the fact that they won the game the way they did, really Atlanta won it for them, doesn't really give me a lot of confidence about the Detroit Lions. So I'm going to take the Colts to win 24-21. That's my final score prediction. Give me the Colts.